Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Dr. G. Narasimhulu Garu, Professor Amita Agrawal Garu, Dr. Prakash, Dr. Sarat Chandra, Dr. Varaprasad, Dr. Raj Kiran, the delegates, ladies and gentlemen, press and media. First of all, I thank you very much for inviting me in the inaugural session of your 4th annual South Zone Indian Rheumatology Conference today at Hyderabad. And I'm very happy to learn that the technical session was just over by 6 p.m. today, and it was very useful. And it will continue for tomorrow also. I also just convey the message from our Health Minister, Dr. Lakshma Reddy, who is just away from Hyderabad and could not make it on time. And he has conveyed his best wishes for the conference and requested me to convey the message from the government of Telangana to you. I'm very happy to learn from the speakers just before me spoke about the purpose and the technical aspects of the conference. As I understand, it's always better to network with each other, exchange the ideas, exchange the knowledge, propagate the knowledge, teach and learn something with each other for the benefit of the society and the people at large. And the professions like super specialties like rheumatology is not so easy to learn and practice. And in India, as I was told, very limited number of medical colleges and institutions have this super specialty, and very limited number of specialists are available to the society at this moment. I also learned that our country, with the huge population, the doctor-patient ratio is quite poor. We are trying to build the capacities. We are trying to build the education system where more and more number of PG seats in our medical colleges and super specialty seats, DM seats in our colleges are sanctioned, and more and more number of qualified people are available. But the requirements are growing every day, and we have to meet the expectations of the people. This year itself, I must tell you, in our state of Telangana, we have got more than 300 PG seats added to our existing seats. And we have also added, if you take the Nizam Institute of Medical Sciences, the 42 super specialty seats have been added this year. So this itself is the government of India and all state governments, our effort is to increase the specialists in our country so that the best possible services are available to our people. And as I understand here, the rheumatology has not drawn that attention of the governments, but I'm sure it will be catching up very, very soon. And on the behalf of the government of Telangana, I would like to say that whatever support is required in this field, government is ready to carry it forward. We have about 3.6 crores of population in Telangana and a huge number of health institutions. You will be surprised to learn that how many people we employ in the health sector. On the regular basis, about 25,000 doctors and all other supporting staff. And on service incentive basis about 30,000 ASA workers at the village level. So you can say about 50,000 people work with us in the government of Telangana. Recently, if you have followed the newspapers and media, the woman who is our ASA worker at the village level, she will be paid about 6,000 rupees per month. So it's not the establishment cost in the government, as you know, it's higher. And if I can compare, you will be understanding, because lots of you work in the private sector. A nurse who start the service in the government, regular nurse, her pay scale starts from 25,000 rupees plus. The first salary itself is, 25,000 rupees plus the DA and other things added, HRA added, it will cost government about 30,000-35,000 rupees. So we pay hugely initially in the government. So the cost of the establishment in the government, health sector or any other sector is quite high. And you will be surprised to know that, our budget this year has crossed almost 7,000 crores per year. So it's a huge spending we do. And right from the sub-center, health sub-center, to the primary health center, to the community health centers and area hospitals, district hospitals, and to the tertiary hospitals and medical colleges, etc., we would like to build the capacities. We would like to train our people. We would like to produce the best people, and along with the private sector, we would like to definitely provide the best of services to all the people of Telangana. And as I said, medical education plus the treatment aspect in our hospitals, we will be providing the best of it. And so far, this particular specialty is concerned, I know Dr. Narasimhulu for many, many years, his efforts in Nizam's Institute of Medical Sciences, in establishing the department, training the people, and bringing them and developing the department is so praiseworthy. I feel that this kind of effort by everybody is required in the government system, which is a public institutions. If you go to the public institutions, you will be surprised to know that we serve more than our capacities. I'll give an example of the Gandhi Hospital here. The sanctioned bed strength about 1,000 beds. At any point of time, we have 1,500 inpatients available there. So it's not that nobody wants to go to the government. It's a huge demand of the government services. There's no dearth of the people demanding services from the government. So we require the best people to be available in the government, and we would like to encourage all the specialties. Of late, we have started transplants, kidney transplants in our Osmania Hospital. You would have seen that. And of course, Nizam Institute of Medical Sciences has been performing it quite regularly. We also, Telangana and the erstwhile government of Andhra Pradesh, is pioneer in having a kind of purchasing the services, buying the services from the private sector. Our Aarogyasri scheme is one scheme which is having about 300 plus hospitals from the private sector in our list, impanel list, and we buy the services from them in the various specialties. And about our budget this year is about 700 crores. So it's the cooperation with the private as well as the strengthening of the government sector. We are taking the healthcare forward. And we are committed to provide the best services. And you being here in the sector of rheumatology, whatever best outcomes after this conference, whatever best cooperation you require from the government, please let us know. Whatever best possible, we would like to consider that in days to come. Now, going towards the general thing, there are the delegates who are from the outside Hyderabad, and there are delegates from outside our country. There are some of you who have come from outside. This is the place. Of course, this is not the right time to be here. This is the hottest month we are having, you know, 40s or temperatures of 40s, but along with the warmth of, you know, temperatures and this thing, we have the warmth of Hyderabad. You please go around the city, of course, at the cooler times in the evenings, and you can have the hospitality of, you know, Hyderabad city, which is more than 400 years old history and a very historical, very cultural city. I also learned that you have cultural programs, the Kuchipudi dance and Perini Natyam, Bharat Natyam. So you please enjoy the evening. Apart from our historical background, which that we have in the city, we also have some new developments that have happened. If you would have come from the airport, if you had used the outer ring road, you'll see that, you know, this is about 160 kilometers around outer ring road, having 150 meters wide right of way, with 8-lane main expressway, 2 lanes either side, the service road, so 12-lane road you have ready. So that has added a lot of growth potential to the city. Any medical establishment, any health establishment in future will have huge potential to prosper here. So I also invite any one of you out from out of Hyderabad to come down and invest here in the health sector. You will reap the benefits. With these few words, I wish this conference a great success. You should come out with lots of technical recommendations and papers to be published in future, and wishing you all the best. Thank you very much for inviting me.